go directly to the program. It will be a play program for children 7 to 14. If you'd like any more information about that, you can contact Circle. There is some contact information in there. If you'd like to remind everyone, please silence your phones. Photography is acceptable. Please no flash. Exits are clearly marked. You have three. The closest may be behind you. Think of an airplane. So just be aware in the event of an emergency, which you don't expect any this evening. There are some lights and some noises throughout the play. If you feel ill, there are lights on in the lobby. And please feel free to take a step outside. With that, please do enjoy the show. And I present to you William Shakespeare's Descendants. Thanks very much.
Obey and be attentive. Canst thou remember a time before we came unto this? from my remembrance. Thank you, father.
My brother and my uncle call it Antonio. I pray thee mark me that a brother should be so perfidious. He who next thyself of all the world I loved, and to him with the manage of my state, was at the time through all sceneries, who was the first, the Prospera, fine duchess, being so reputed in dignity and for the liberal arts without parallel. Those being all my study, the government.
rolled away his tremble.
Yeah.
His tread tried to shake
my green spirit. Who is so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
A soul! But felt a fever for that, who played some tricks of desperation. All but mariners plunged into the foaming brine, the vessel.
Then,
all fire with me. The queen's son, Ferdinand, with hair upstairing. Then, like reeds, not hair, was the first man that let's cry, "Hell is empty and all the devils are here!"
But that's my spirit. But was this not my shore?
Close by, ministers.
But are they areas safe?
Not a hair perish.
On the sustaining garments, not a blemish. Fresher than before. And as thou bakest me, in troops I have dispersed them about the isle. The queen's son have I landed by himself, whom I left cooling of the air with sighs, in an odd angle of the island city, his arms in this sad knot.
Of the queen's ship, the mariners say how thou hast disposed and all the rest of the fleet.
Safely in harbor is the queen's ship, in the deep nook where thou once called to me a midnight night to fetch dew from the still best vermouths. There she stood. The mariners all under hatches stowed, who with a charm joined to their suffered labor, and as for the rest of the fleet, which I have dispersed, they have all met again and are now upon the Mediterranean float, bound sadly home for Naples, supposing they saw the queen's ship wrecked and her great person perish.
Ariel, thy charge is exactly what but there's more work. What is the time of the day?
Past the mid-season.
These two glasses. The time twixt six and now must by us both be spent most preciously.
Is there more toil? Since thou dost give me pains, let me remember thee that which thou hast promised, which is not yet delivered me.
What is it thou canst demand?
My liberty?
Before the time be out, no more.
I
you all over.
For this, be sure, tonight thou shalt have cranks, side stitches that shall pen thy record. Urchin shall forth at fast the night to work all exercise on thee. Thou shalt be pinched as thick as honeycomb, each pinch more stinging than bees that made of.
I must eat my dinner. This island is mine! My sick rest, my mother, which thou takest from me. When thou first came, thou strokest me and madest much of me. Wouldst give me water with berries in it and teach me how to tame the bigger light and how the less that burns by day and night. Then I loved thee, showed thee all the qualities of the isle, the fresh springs, the bright, its barren place, and fertile. Curse the eye that did so! All the charms of Sycorax, toads, beetles, bats, light on you. Ride of all the subjects that you have, whom first was mine own queen. Here you stymie to this hard rock, whilst you keep from me the rest of the island!
Thou most lying slave, who strikes may move not kindness. I have used thee, filth as thou art, with humane care, and lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Would it had been done, thou didst prevent me. I am equal else in this island with Caliban to
court, slave! Which any prince of goodness will not take me capable of all ill! I pitied thee. Took pains to make thee speak, taught thee each hour one thing or other. Witness thou not, savage, no thing unheeding, but was gabble like a thing most brutish. I endowed thy purposes with words that made them known. Thy vile race, thou haven't learned, had that in it which good natures could not abide to be with. Never wast thou deservedly confined into this rock, which thou deservest more than a prison.
You talk in language, and my profit on it is I know how to curse. The red pots rid you for learning me your language!
I see hence. Fuel, and be quick. Thou art best to answer other business. Struckst thou malice, if thou neglect'st, or dost unwillingly what I demand, I'll rack thee full of old cramps, fill all thy bones with aches, make thee roar that we shall tremble at thy din.
Prithee no more! I must obey. Her heart is of such power that will control my dance, not set to make a vassal of him.
So slave hits.
Thank you.
instruction give on how I may bear me here. My prime request, which I do last pronounce. So you wonder, be you made or no?
No wonder, sir, but certainly a maid.
My language? Heavens, I am the best of men speak this speech where it is spoken.
How? The best? What work be if the Queen of Naples heard thee?
A single thing, that wonders to hear thee speak of Naples. She does hear me, and as she does, I weep. I myself and Naples, who with mine eyes, never since the dead, beheld the Queen, my mother, rapt.
What for me?
Yes, faith, and all her ladies, the Duke of Milan and her brave son, being twain.
The Duchess of Milan and her more braver daughter, truly, and her now fit to it. For sight they changed eyes, delicate Ariel, all set in bravery. A word, sir, I fear you have done yourself a wrong. A word.
Why speak to others so ungently? This is the first man that ever I saw, the first man I sighed for, fitting with my mouth in that direction.
No, if your affection is not going forth, I would make you the Queen of Naples.
Stop, sir, one word more.
They are both in either's powers,
but this swift business I must not easy make, lest too light a winning make the prize light. A word. I charge thee, thou attend me. Thou dost here usurp the name thou knowest not, and hast put thyself upon this island as a spy, to win it from me, the Lord on it.
No, as I am a man.
There's nothing ill can live in such a temple. When the good spirit has so fair a house, others will strive to dwell in it.
Come, speak not you for him, he is a traitor. Follow me, I'll manacle thy neck and feet together. Sea water shalt thou drink, thy food shall be the fresh brook mussels, withered roots and husks wherein the acorns cradle. Come, follow.
No, I will resist such entertainment until mine enemy has more power.
Oh, my dear mother, make not too rash a trial on him, for he is gentle and not fearful.
What, my quick, my tutor? Put thy sword up, traitor, who makes the show but dares not strike. Thy conscience is so possessed with guilt. Come from thy lord, for I did here disarm thee with this stick and make thy weapon drop.
Beseech you, mother.
Hence, hang not on my garments.
Mother, take pity, all thee is shorty.
Silence. One word more will make me chide thee about thee. What? An advocate for an impostor. Thou thinkst there is no such shapes as he, having seen but him and Caliban. Foolish wench, to the most of men this is a Caliban, and they to him are angels.
My affections are then most humble. I have no desire to see a goodlier man.
Come on, obey. Thy nerves are in their infancy again.
So they are. My spirits, as in a dream, are all bound up. My mother's lost the weakness which I feel, the rack of all of my friends, though this woman's threats to whom I am subdued are but light to me. But I look through my prison once a day, behold this maiden. All corners of the earth, let liberty make use of space, enough have I in such a prison.
It works. Come on. Thou hast done well, fine Aaron. Follow me. Hark what else thou shalt do.
Take comfort, sir. As a better nature than she appears by speech, this is unwanted, which now comes from her.
Thou shalt be free as mountain prince, but then do all points of my command.
To the syllable!
Come, follow. Speak not you for him.
thinks if she or Adriana for a good wager for speaking to her.
The old man.
The cockroach.
Done the wager.
A laughter.
A match.
Though this island seems to be a desert.
No, you're kidding.
Uninhabitable and almost inaccessible.
Yet,
it must needs be of subtle, delicate, and tender temperance.
Temperance was a delicate wench.
I am the succubus she most learnedly delivers.
The air breathes upon us here most sweet.
As if it had lungs and rot once.
Or is perfect human by a fen.
Here is everything I can see to select.
A true saint means to live.
That there is not a little.
How lush and musky the grass looks. How green!
The ground indeed is
with an eye of green in it.
Passions is not much.
No, she doesn't mistake the truth totally.
But the weird gift is, which is indeed almost beyond credit.
As many Dutch berries are.
Then our garments, being as they were, drenched in the sea, hold notwithstanding their freshness in cloths, but being rather nude, than stained with salt water.
If but one of her pockets would speak, would not say she knew
why. I, or very falsely, pocket up her court.
Who thinks our garments are as fresh as when we put them on first in that creek? At the marriage of the king's fair daughter, farewell to the king of Tunis.
It was a sweet marriage. We prosper well in our turn.
Tunis was never graced before with such a paragon to their queen.
Not since Widow Dennis' time.
Widow? A pox on that! How came that widow in? Widow Dido.
What if she had said widower Aeneas? Too good lord, how you take it?
Widow Dido, said you. You made me study of that. She was of Carthage, not Tunis. This Tunis is a lady who was Carthage. Carthage. I assure you.
Which impossible matter will she make easy next?
She thinks she will carry this island home in her pocket, give it her son for an apple.
And sowing the kernels of it in the sea, bring forth more islands.
Aye.
Why, in good time.
Lady, we were talking about our garments, more precious we were at Tunis, at the marriage of your daughter, who is now queen.
Aye, and the rarest that ever the heir came there.
Fate, I beseech you, Widow Dido.
Oh, Widow Dido. Aye, Widow Dido.
It's lovely, my garments, as fresh as the first day I wore. I mean, in a sort.
That sort was well fished for.
When I wore it after your daughter's marriage, you crammed these words into my ears and something of my sense. Would I had never married my daughter there. For coming thence, my son is lost. And in my right, she too, who is so far from Italy removed, I never again shall see her. Thou, mine heir of Naples and of Milan, which strange fish hath made his meal on me?
A man of the England, I saw him meet the surges under him and trod upon their backs. He trod the water, whose enemy he flung aside, and rested the surge most swollen than that him. His bold head above the contentious waves he kept, and oared himself with good arms and lusty strokes to the shore, that o'er his wave worn face his bow, that stooping to relieve him. I not doubt he came alive to land. No, he's gone.
Madam, you may thank yourself for this great loss. That would not bless our Europe with your daughter, but rather lose her to an African, where she at least vanished from your eye, who hath cause to let the grief on it.
Pretty, peace.
You were kneeled to and importuned otherwise by all of us, and the fair soul herself, way between loathness and obedience, at which end of the being should bow. We have lost your son, I fear, forever. Milan and Naples have more widows in them of this business making than we bring men to comfort them. Fault's your own.
Sebastian, the truth you speak, no blasphemy, gentleness, and time to speak in it. You love the soul, but you should bring the blast.
Very well.
And most urgently.
It is foul weather and salt that we give you.
Foul weather?
Very foul.
That at a plantation of this isle, my lady.
She's still open, that'll see.
The docks are mellows.
With me on, so what I do?
Escape being drunk for want of wine.
I'm the commonwealth of thy contraries, excuse. No kind of traffic would I admit. No name of magistrate. Let us should believe, Your Highness, and did it to minister occasion to these gentlemen who have such sensible and nimble lungs that they always have to laugh at nothing.
That was you we laughed at.
Well, this kind of very fooling of nothing to you, so you may continue and laugh at nothing still.
Oh, what a blow was there to
you to love all the level.
You are turning on a great metal. You lift the moon out of the sphere, she will continue it 5 weeks without changing.
It would so, and then you will back out.
Nay, good my lady, be not angry.
No, I warrant you. I will not venture my discretion so easily. You will not be a sleeping one. I'm very happy.
Go sleep and hear us.
What? Also soon asleep? I wish my eyes could reach themselves to shut up my thoughts. If I were inclined to do so.
Please you, madam. Do not permit the heavy offer of it. Seldom is a sorrow when a doth it is a comfort.
Me too, my lady, will guard your person while you take your rest.
Thank you.
Aren't you
sad?
What a strange drowsiness possesses.
It is the quality of the client.
Why does nothing our eyelids sink? I find not myself disposed to sleep.
Nor I. My spirits are nimble. They dropped as by consent, fell together all as by a thunderstorm. What might, worthy Sebastian, oh, what might? And yet, the occasion speaks to me. My strong imagination sees a crown dropping upon thy head.
Art thou waking?
Do you not hear me speak?
I do, and surely it is a sleepy language which thou speakest out of thy sleep. But what is it thou didst say? This is a strange repose to be sleeping with eyes wide open, standing, speaking, moving, yet so fast asleep.
Noble Sebastian, thou lets thy fortune sleep. Die, means whilst thou art waking.
Thou wilt snore distinctly. There's meaning in thy snores.
More serious than my custom. You must be so too, if he be. Which to do? Trebles me up.
Well, I am standing water.
I will teach you how to flow.
Do so. To ebb, where it is very soft, shall be.
Oh, if you but knew how you the purpose cherish, whiles thus you mock it, how in stripping it, you more invest it. Ebbing men indeed most often do so near the bottom run by their own fear or sloth.
Prithee, say on. Setting of thine eye in sheep proclaimed a matter from thee and a birth indeed bestows thee much to yield.
Thus, sir, this lady of weak remembrance, this who shall be this little memory when she is earth, hath fear almost persuaded, for she's a spirit of persuasion, only professes to persuade. The queen, her son's alive? 'Tis as impossible that he's undrowned as she that sleeps here swims.
I have no hope that he's undrowned.
Oh, out of that no hope, what great hope have you? No hope that way is another way, so high a hope that even ambition cannot pierce a week beyond, without discovery there. Will you grant with me that Ferdinand is drowned?
He's gone.
And tell me, who's the next heir of Naples?
Clara.
She that is queen of Tunis, she that dwells 10 leagues beyond man's life, she that from whom Naples can have no note, unless the sun repose, the man who moves too slow, till newborn chins be rough and razorable. She that from whom we were all sea swallowed, though some cast again, and by that destiny to perform an act whereof what's past this prologue, what to come in yours at my discharge.
Stuff is this, how say you? It's true my sister's daughter's queen of Venus, so is she heir of Naples, twixt which regions there is some space.
A space that seems to cry out, how shall that Clarabelle measure us back in Naples? Keep in Tunis! And that Sebastian wake. Say this were death that now hath seized them. Why? They were no worse than now they are. There be that can rule Naples, as well as she that sleeps. Lords that can prate as amply and unnecessarily as this Gonzola. I myself can make a chunk of this deep chat. The mind that I do. What a sleep were this for your advancement. Do you understand?
Thinks I do.
And how is your content?
tender your own good fortune.
I remember you did supplant your sister Prospera.
True. And look at how my garments sit upon me, much cleaner than before. My sister's servants were then my fellows. Now, they are my men.
For your conscience.
Sir, where lies that? If 'twere Kai, 'twould put me to my slipper. But I feel not this deity in my bosom. 20 consciences that stand twixt me and Milan, candy be they and melt ere they molest. Here lies your sister, no better than the earth she lies upon. If she were that which now she's like, that's dead, whom I with this obedient steel, 3 inches of it could lay to bed forever, while you doing thus to the perpetual wink for I might put this ancient morsel, this Lady Prudence, who shall not upbraid our course. For all the rest, they'll take suggestion as a cat laps milk. They'll tell the clock to any business that we say befits the hour.
Thy case, dear friend, shall be my precedent. As thou gast Milan, I'll come by Naples. Draw thy sword! One stroke shall free thee from the tribute which thou payest, and I, the king, shall love thee.
Draw it together. And when I rear my hand, do you thus fall upon Gonzola.
Oh. One word.
My mistress Pourshariati foresees the danger that you befriend Ariel, and sends me forth. Or else your project dies to keep them living. One minute of snoring by. Open I can speak. If for life you keep a care, shake off slumber and beware. Awake! Awake!
Now it must both be certain!
Just pursue the king! Why? How now, hope? Awake!
Why are you drawn? Wherefore this ghastly looking?
What's the matter?
Whilst we stood here, securing your repose, even now we heard a hollow burst of bellowing like bulls, or rather, lions. Did not wake you. Struck my ear most terribly.
I heard nothing.
Oh, 'twas a noise to frighten monsters here. To make an earthquake. Sure, 'twas the mournful home of herd of lions.
Gracious, Gonzola. In my unbelief, I heard a humming and a strange one too, which did awake me. I shaked you, lady, and cried. As mine eyes opened, I saw their weapons drawn. There was a noise, that's fair. Tis best we stand upon our guard, then we quit this place. Let's show our weapons.
Lead off this ground, and let's make further search for my poor son.
Let's keep him from this beast. You shore me out of him.
Lead away.
My mistress, to her heart, shall know what I have done. Go, queen. Go safely on to seek thy son.
Affections that the sun soaks up. Balls, veins, glands, a prosperous head fall, and they burn my entry like disease. Spirits hear me. Thy knees must curse! Now a pinch will frighten me with urgent shows, but lead me like a firebrand in the dark, unless she bid him. Every trifle I may set upon me, sometimes like apes that mow and chatter and after bite me, then like hedgehogs who lie tumbling in my bare way and mouth their pricks at my footfall, then I all wound with adders who with cloven tongues do hiss me into madness. Now go, here comes the spirit of hers. She don't bet me for bringing the woody slowly.
Thunder as it did before. I know not where to hide my head. Yon
way is to creep under his gabardine. There is no other shelter hereabouts. Misery acquaints man with strange bedfellows. I will hear shrouds of the dregs of the storm be passed.
And his own to the sea, boy. I'll let her go high. This is a strange tune to sing in a man's fiddle. Here's my comfort. Oh, rest her in the boat's way, anchor high.
More of this.
Yeah, man, I'll pass, but,
me, and thy dog, and thy bush.
Well, good, man. Yeah, come, drink to it.
By this good light, this is a very shallow monster. I can hear him. A very weak monster. The man of the moon. The most poor, credulous monster. Well-drawn monster in red suit. I'll show thee every fertile inch of the island, and I'll kiss thy foot. I prithee, be my god. By this light, this is the most perfidious and drunken monster. When his god is asleep, he'll rob his bottle. Oh, I'll kiss thy foot. I'll swear myself thy subject. I laugh myself to death at this puppy-headed monster. A most stern monster. I can find in my heart to beat him.
Come, kiss him.
But that poor monster's a trick, an abominable monster. I'll show thee the best springs, and I'll pluck thee berries. I'll fish for thee, and get thee wood. I'll bear her no more sticks, but follow thee, thou wine-drinker's man. Most ridiculous monster to make a wonder of a poor drunkard. I bring thee, let me bring thee where crabs grow, and I, with my long nails, will dig thee pigments, show thee a jay's nest, instruct thee a snare the nimble marmoset. I'll bring thee to clustering filberts, and sometimes I'll get thee young scandals from the rock. Wilt thou go with me?
Aye, monster, we shall go with you, with no more talking. Trinculo!
Yeah?
Yeah. Well, the queen and her company being grounded, we each shall be sovereign in here.
Yeah!
Bear my bow, man, and we shall fill the horn up.
Farewell, master! Farewell, farewell!
A howling monster, a drunken monster!
No more dams I'll make for fish, nor fetch it firing at requiring, nor spit treachery, nor wash dish. Ban, ban, to Caliban, as a new master. Once a new man. Freedom! Haide! Freedom! Freedom! Haide! Freedom!
Thank you.
the world. Full many a lady I vied with question of, and the harmony of their tongues hath in the bondage brought my too diligent ear. For many virtues have I left many women, never with any so full soul, but some defect in her did quarrel with the noblest graces that she owed and put into the foil. But you, so perfect and so peerless, are made of every creature's best.
I know other of my sex, nor has been any that they call men, but you, dear friend. How features are abroad, I am skillless of, but by my modesty, the jewel in my dower, I would not wish any companion in the world with you. Nor can imagination form a shape besides yourself to like of. But I prattle something too wildly, and my mother's reason that ever he forgets.
I have in my commission, Miranda, a prince. I would think a king, I would not so. I would no more suffer this wooden slavery than to suffer the flesh fly blow my mouth. Hear my soul speak. The very instant that I saw you, my heart flew to your service, and there resides to make me slave to you. And it is for your sake that I am this patient bogman.
You love me?
Oh, heaven and earth, bear witness to the sound of the ground that confess with kind of end if I speak true, probably in Berkeley's best looking exhibition. I, beyond limit of all else in the world, I do love, prize, and honor you.
I am a fool to weep at that which I am glad of.
Their encounter of two most rare affections. Rain grace on that which breeds between them.
Word for week.
My unworthiness. I dare not offer what I desire to give, and much less take what I shall die and want. This is trifling. And all the more it seeks to hide itself, the greater bulk it shows. Hence, bashful cunning, and prompts me, pure and maiden innocence. I am your wife if you will marry me. If not, I'll die your maid. To be your fellow, you may deny me, but I'll be your servant, will you or no?
My mistress, and I, thus humble ever.
My husband, then?
I, with a heart as willing as bondage now free. Take my hand.
Mine, my heart is. And now farewell. Till half an hour hence.
A thousand pounds.
Once again, the suit I made to thee.
I shall kneel and tell it, and I shall stand and listen. And so
told thee before, I am subject to a tyrant, a sorceress that by her cunning hath cheated me of the island.
Thou liest!
Thou liest, thou just monkey! Now, I would my valiant master would destroy thee, I do not lie.
Trinculo, by this hand I shall rearrange some of your teeth.
Why, that's nothing.
Good. Keep mum then. Proceed, Master Master.
I see. By sorcery she got the sign. For me she got it. Thy greatest will, revenge on her, for I know thou bearest. But this thing dare not.
This is true.
Thou shalt be lord of it, and I'll serve thee.
How can this be accomplished? Dost thou know where her party is?
Yea, my lord, I'll yield her to thee asleep. But thou mayest not. A nail into her head.
Thou liest, thou canst not.
What a fine idiot is this, thou scurvy patch? I do beseech thy greatness. Give him blows, and take his bottle from him. When that's gone, we shall drink up the brine, for I'll not show that it quick freshes are.
Trinculo, if thou bid the toothsome monster bait, then you keep up. How gives the master any further, I shall put thee out and make a stockfish of thee.
Why, what's that? I did nothing. I'll go farther on.
Didst thou not say that the monster gave the lies?
Thou liest!
Oh, what? Give me the lies, shall you?
Marina, you're a monster, and the devil take your fingers.
further stand off. Stand further off and go. Proceed, Master.
He beats him enough, my lord. After a while, I'll beat him too.
Stand further off.
Proceed. Why, as I told thee, there's a custom with her in the afternoon to sleep. There, thou mayest bring her. Having first seized her books, or with a log, batter his skull, or punch him with a stake, or cut a weasel end with thy knife. Remember first, to possess her books, without that she is but as sub as I am, and not one spirit's command. They all behave her as rudely as I. Burn but her books. She has brave utensils, for so she calls them, which, when she has a house, she'll deck with all. And that most deeply to consider is the beauty of her daughter. She herself falls for a non-pariah. I never saw a woman like she.
Is she so brave, alas?
Aye, my lord. She'll become thy bed, I warrant, and bring thee forth brave brood.
Master, I shall kill thy mistress and marry her daughter. And she and I shall be king and queen of the island. And you and Trinculo will be my viceroys. Dost thou like the plan, Trinculo? Trinculo. That's not like the flag!
Ah, my balls!
That's not like the flag! Alright, well, good. Give me thine hand. I am sorry that I should be thee, but remember to keep a civil tongue in your head.
Within this half hour will she be asleep. Without destroying her then.
Tell my word of honor.
Thou makest me merry! I am full of pleasure! Ha ha! Let's be Jacon! Will you show the catch thou taught me but while here?
Alright, I'll take any reason. Trinculo, let us sing!
Again.
This shall be an interesting island because I'll get my music.
music for free when Prospera is destroyed.
Yes, that's going to be my advice.
I've been suing.
work a great time after now gins to fight the spirit.
I do seem to have set the joints.
Follow quickly hindered them from what this meant to see. Follow, I pray you.
Celebrate, and so donation free. Juno.
Thus, my bounteous sister, go with me to bless this swain, that they may prosperous be and honored in their
born near herself.
Monster.
Monster.
That fairy that thought to say was but a good fairy has done not to play the jack with us.
Monster! I do smell horse piss, and which my nose is in great indignation.
As is mine, in fact, by this hand, if I were thee.
Thou art but a lost monster. I prithee, my king, give me thy favor still. Be patient. The prize I'll bring thee to shall hoodwink this mischance. Therefore speak softly. All's hushed as midnight yet.
Aye,
but to lose our bottles in the pool.
That is the worst of the tragedies of all. That's the saddest.
This is more to me than my wedding. And this for your harmless fairy monster.
I shall get my bottle back, though I've yearned my ears in the effort for it.
Prithee, my king, be quiet. Seest thou here? This is the mouth of the cell. No noise. Enter. That good mischief that shall make this island thine own forever. And I, thy Caliban, bray thy footlick.
Well, give me thine hand, for I do begin to have money.
King Stephano! Oh, peer, a worthy Stephano! My wardrobe's here for thee. Let it alone now, fool, it must trash!
Oh, then. Monster, we know it belongs to a frippery!
Oh, King Stephano!
Hey, Trinculo, I have that garment, I should have that garment.
Thy grace shall have it. Dropsy, drown this fool! What do you mean, don't you want such luggage? Let it alone! Do the murder first! If she discovers us from toe to crown, she'll fill our skin with pictures, make us strange stuff.
Quiet, you. Oh, good mistress Lion, I believe that this jerkin is my jerkin, and therefore it shall be that thou might become a bold jerkin.
Do, do. Let me steal my line and level it. Your grace.
Line and level. That is
clever. And here, have a garment for us. And for in thy kingdom, we shall rule and have reward for wit and line and level is witty. So there, have a garment.
Ah, oh, monster. Put some lime upon your fingers and away with the rest. I shall have none on it. We'll lose our time and be turned into barnacles or apes with foreheads filled with this low.
Put thy finger to thy lips, monster.
Take all of this and put it near where my hog's head is.
Take this.
And this.
And this.
Though with their high wrongs I destructive. You elves of hills, brooks, standing lakes, and groves, and you that on sands with printless foot to chase the ebbing Neptune, to defy him when he comes back. You demi-puppets that by moonshine to green sour ringlets make, whereof the hue not bites. You whose pastime is to make midnight mushrooms that rejoice to hear the solemn curfew. By whose aid, weak masters though you be, I have bedimmed the noontide sun, called forth the mutinous winds, and twixt the green sea and azure vault set roaring war. To the dread rattling thunder have I been in fire, and rifted Jove's stout oak with his own bolt. The strong base promontory have I made shake, and by the spurs plucked up the pine and cedar. Graves in my command have waked their sleepers, oaked and let them forth by my so potent hand. This rough magic here I adjure. When I have acquired some heavenly music, which even now I do, to work mine end upon their senses that this airy charm is for, I'll break my staff, bury it certain fathoms in the earth, and deeper than did ever plummet sound, I'll drown my hope.
Thank you.
know thou must restore.
If thou beest Prospera, give us the particulars of thy preservation. How thou hast met us here, who 3 hours since were wrecked upon this shore, where I have lost.
Well, sure, point of the reference is. My dear Sumter, I am woe for it. Irreparable is the loss, and patience as it is past your cure.
I'd rather think you have not sought her help, of whose soft grace for the life lost I have for sovereign aid to rest myself content.
You the one lost?
Grace me as late. It's horrible to make the dear loss of I means much weaker than you may call to comfort you. For I have lost my daughter.
A daughter? Oh heavens, they were both living in Naples, the king and queen there. That they were, I wish myself for what had been that goosey bed where my son lies.
When did you lose your daughter?
In this last tempest. Perceive these lords do so much admire this encounter that they do that they devour their reason. And scarcely in their eyes do offices of truth. Their words are natural breath. But howsoever you have been jostled from your senses, know for certain that I am Prospera, that very duchess who was thrust forth in Milan, who most strangely upon this shore where you were wrecked, was landed to be the lord on it. No more yet of this, for 'tis a chronicle of day by day, not a relation for a breakfast, nor befitting this first meeting. Welcome, man. This cells my court. Here have I few attendants and subjects none abroad. Pray you look in. My dukedom, since you have given me again, I will requite thee with this good a thing. At least bring forth a wonder to content you as much as you might.
Sweet lord, you play me false.
No, dearest love, I would not for the world.
Yes, for a score of kingdoms you would wrangle, and I would call it fair play.
If this prove a vision of the island, one dear son shall I twice lose.
Most high miracle.
The seas threaten. They are merciful, and I curse them without cause.
Now, all the blessings of the grandmother compass thee about my eyes, and say how thou canst here.
Oh, wonder. How many goodly creatures have we here? Oh, how beauteous mankind is. How brave new world that has such people in it.
It's new to thee.
What is this maid who thou hast at play? Your elf's acquaintance cannot be 3 hours. Is she the goddess that has summoned us and brought us thus together?
She is mortal, man, but by immortal providence, she is mine. I chose her when I could not ask my mother for her advice, nor thought I had one. She is daughter to this famous Duchess of Milan, of whom I've heard such renown that I never foresaw, from whom I received a second life, and a second mother this woman makes her to me.
I am hers. But oh, how oddly will it sound that I must ask my child forgiveness.
Fair man, stop. Let us not burden our remembrances with the heaviness that's gone.
I've only wept if she must go here to this.
Look down, you gods, and on this couple drop a blessed crown. For it is you that have chopped forth the way which brought us hither.
I say it.
Was Milan first from Milan, or should his kingdom Naples? Clara, her husband?
And Ferdinand, her brother? Prospera,
her dukedom in the isle?
Give me your hands. My grief and sorrow still embrace this heart that doth not wish you joy.
Be it so.
Amen. Stranger mazes ever men trod, and there is in this business more than nature has ever conduct of. Some oracle must rectify our knowledge.
Man, my liege, do not infest your mind with the beating on the strangeness of this business. At King Pleasure, which shall be shortly, single I'll resolve you, which to you may seem most probable of every these happened accidents. So let be cheerful and think of each thing well. Come hither, spirit. Is it Caliban in his impending spree, a tide of stone? There are yet missing of your company some few odd lads that you remember not. Strong.
worship